Thermistor's Poinsettias of 1934 is very typical of her interest in flower paintings, still lifes, but more generally, more specifically, flower paintings. And it's a very fine example of her interest in the flower paintings. It's very lush. I think what's most obvious about this is just this absolute reveling in these shades of red and pink, which are then offset by the complementarity of the green, and very in the background, some of the green audaciously worked into the pink background in thick impasto. It's a very lush, sensual, beautiful painting, very typical of her style at the time. Ermiston painted flowers almost obsessively, these still lifes, and they become more than just still life paintings or simply transcriptions of flowers. In fact, they're an invitation into her private world, because often included in the paintings would be the various objects that she would have in her studio. So a bowl like this, for example, would be typical of the kinds of things that Ermiston collected, and they always appear in her still life paintings in one way or another. So it's almost like we're taken into this intensely private space that becomes a celebration of a kind of enjoyment of these beautiful things. The poinsettias are a theme that you turn to again and again. These intensely red bracts of the poinsettia, of course, lending themselves very well to her interest in things that were exotic and interesting and that had a compelling visual interest in their own right. So not surprisingly that she would return again and again to poinsettias. This painting itself is quite interesting in that it was exhibited at the Empire Exhibition in Johannesburg in 1936. Ermiston had three works on that exhibition. And that exhibition, in a sense, marked kind of a turning point in her career. Because it's after that she started getting better critical acclaim, and the South African government started promoting her work by buying it and putting it in its missions abroad. Because up to that point, the public was very, or rather critics and the public, very divided on Ermiston's style. It was somehow too assertively modern, too aggressive, too expressive for the conservative South African art world at the time. It's a historically very interesting and important painting. But as I've said at the start, very much within her interest in the still life as a way of sort of accessing an aspect of her intensely personal vision, an intensely personal sense of things. And for me, what's always interesting about Stern's still lives is that they don't carry any of that sort of heavy, lugubrious symbolism of the memento mori with which the genre is usually associated, but rather they seem to be a celebration of life, of color, of sensuality, and, you know, of beauty.